It's no secret that the Fort Smith Convention Center is facing some financial troubles. And in the wake of all that, a new Expo Center opened in the area, which could take even more business from the Convention Center. 4029's Kelly Johnson spoke with representatives from both sides to get their take.
The convention center is in what some call a financially unstable future. Gary Campbell, a director on the Fort Smith City Board, talks about possible solutions to the funding troubles.
There's been a lot of discussions, a lot of ideas laid on the table.
The board met a few months back to discuss a possible prepared food tax that would add 1 cent onto every prepared food purchase, not exclusive to just restaurants.
Prepared food any place. If you go into Harps, and you buy a roasted chicken that they roasted there, that's prepared.
And in the midst of all of this, the old Phoenix Village Mall was transformed into the privately owned and funded Phoenix Expo Center.
We are full service, so we do have 3 catering kitchens, a full service staff here, and we're just able to do anything from A to Z for our clients.
Ronica says business is booming.
Christmas season is really exciting for us. We are just really booked throughout the Christmas season.
It would seem the two centers would collide in a fight for business, but representatives on both sides say they'd rather think of themselves as complementary rather than competitive.
Glad to see them here, and I think the more ways we can get people coming to Fort Smith, the better.
We're just excited to be in the market as well and work together. If we can't meet a client's needs, we know they can. If they can't, we know we can. So we're just going to work together.
Kelly Johnson, 4029 News.
Gary Campbell says it will be spring at the earliest before voters have a chance to weigh in on whether or not they want the prepared food tax to become a choice on the ballot.